Another day, another Jeep, another adventure. I've just come back from a rather extensive work trip and I am quite exhausted since I haven't gotten a break from it. However, Jeep has sent us their top of the line Meridian Overland 4x4. And today, I think it's the best excuse to take the day off, talk all about the Meridian 4x4 and take a nice chill day out. Also, as is TDH tradition, we're going to take it on an adventure. So, let's get right into it. JP.
Our plan of action for the day is to go to a small cafe just before Ambi Valley. We will be taking the expressway to Lonavala, doing some tomfoolery around the back end roads of the hill station and then driving up the hill to Tiger Point to see what the car's dynamics are like. Overall, we should get a good idea of what the car is like in pretty much any scenario you throw at it. But first, we start with the highway.
Now you might be wondering, where am I headed off to? I'm headed off to a nice little spot on the way to Ambi Valley called Maka Bava. And it's got some really nice cuisine that's slightly Parsi, and it's also got a couple of nice drinks. So I'm heading out there to grab a little bite and then drive back to the office. The weather is a little indecisive. We've crossed a tunnel where it was Pune side, pretty sunny, and Lonavala side, rather gloomy, as you can see from outside right now. So we are just heading out, and it is going to be the best test bed to see how is the car going to be in the city, on the highway, and up some twisties. So when things get a little hot, that's exactly what we're going to test. And how about its comfort? It's fantastic. I've covered maybe 42 kilometers. It's given me 16 kilometers to the liter and it has taken me 45 minutes to cover this much distance. According to those figures, the car is doing pretty decently and we have also been cruising at 80, maybe 100 kilometers an hour. And it's been a fairly good ride. It is rather plush and quiet on highways and the sound system might sound impressive, but it could do with a little better sound quality. In terms of refinement, it is rather smooth, as I said before, and there are no form of drone noises coming into the cabin. That would be very justified since there are a lot of soft touch leathers and materials all over the cabin, making it a rather nice place to be too.
So what is the difference between a standard Meridian and a Meridian Overland? Well, it is mainly aesthetic changes, but boy oh boy, do these changes make the Meridian feel like a luxury car. This particular spec is finished in dark green with the brown or tan interior, and it feels really royal. You get 18-inch wheels, chrome highlights on the outside and copper inserts inside. The seats now say Overland. You get suede as well to give it that premium touch, and overall this thing doesn't feel like a Jeep, but rather a proper luxury car.
In terms of tech, you've got a couple of riding modes, sand, mud, snow and auto, and you've also got a 9-speed automatic gearbox that is fairly smooth if you're not worrying about it. But when you're pushing the car, yeah, it does feel a little sluggish, but that's what you'd expect from a car like this. You're not going to want a snappy gearbox that basically shifts aggressively. You want something that shifts smoothly and doesn't let you know that you're shifting it. So yes, we are almost done with the expressway, and in terms of highway capabilities, a very nice car, a very comfortable car, and definitely it's not a tiring car to drive at all. It's quite supple on the highway, and at high speeds it can take pretty good bumps at a pretty good rate. So it is a comfy car, no doubt, on the highways. If you are going to be mile munching, you'll be happy with the figures and you will definitely be taking this on long trips because it is such a dependable car on the road. So yeah, highway test, check. Haven't gotten this breath of fresh air from the cold air of Lonavala that has just given us a shock of rain in the middle of, I think, the hottest summer in Maharashtra. The car is doing pretty well. In the highways, I was fairly impressed with its mileage. And through the city, we've been basically dwindling around in Lonavala for around half an hour. And it's been returning 8.6 kilometers to the liter with a little bit of heavy-footed driving, which is something that you would expect from a regular 2-liter car in any format, which is good news. That means this car is fairly fuel efficient, and you can consider it to be as fuel efficient as you can expect something of this caliber to give you. And in fact, I would think this is impressive because it's such a heavy and massive car. It's still giving you 8.6 kilometers while you're stuck in stop and go traffic. So yes, you are going to be able to enjoy this car, and it's pretty livable with in terms of maintenance. But now is what I would consider the real test. I'm going to be going up the hill towards Ambi Valley, which is a very fun drive and it is rather engaging. So best believe I am going to be pushing the car a little bit more, and we can expect those numbers to go down. But by how much is the real question? And is it any good? Am I going to be happy at the end? All to find out. So let's go. The Meridian as a dynamic drive is really not what it's meant to be doing, but it does that job fairly well. The 9-speed gearbox, as I mentioned, is a little lazy. However, it isn't something that's actually going to bother you in automatic, even when you're pushing the car a little bit. So the good thing is that it's rather smooth, and you're not going to be shackled about while shifting gears, even in manual mode. It is a little late to respond, but it can be dealt with. And in terms of driving dynamics, these FSD struts do a really good job at keeping you flat, even while being rather aggressive in the corners. It stays fairly planted, and it still gives you that rugged feeling you would expect from a large SUV. So it still is rather nice to drive, and if you're going to be taking it up a corner, you can enjoy it. But don't be expecting ridiculous amounts of performance, because it's not meant to do that. However, the brakes are nice. If you brake, the car does have quite a lot of stopping power. But there's one thing that is not keeping up with the car per se, and that is the tires. Any form of dynamic inputs, which could be taking a corner a bit too fast or stamping on the brakes, you will hear those tires squeal very easily. So if you have a Meridian and you'd like to get a little bit more performance, believe me, a new set of tires or a nicer set of tires will really help the way the car drives. In terms of fuel economy, we've not been pushing it really hard, and the mileage says equally the same. I'm getting around 8.4 kilometers a liter up the Ambi Valley hill, and we've been doing 50-60 kilometers an hour constantly, and it's been rather nice. It's not been a hard push. It isn't what you would expect as direct. It is rather numb. It is very light, giving very subtle inputs of feedback. However, it is there. It is telling you what's going on under the road, which is fairly good news. You don't really feel that in quite a lot of SUVs, and it's usually Ram Bharose when you chuck it into a corner. But this car definitely does give you feedback, even though it is in a muted manner. So would I pick this up as my apocalypse machine, or would I pick this up as my family SUV? Maybe. Where in the world have I reached? Okay, so we have just reached Lonavala, and we've gone a little bit off-roading. It is a rather capable car, but now that we are in a pretty place and the weather is basically everything at once right now, let's talk about the design of the Overland. It is Slightly different to the limited version, you get a chrome grille in the front. The body cladding is color painted, and you now get new 18-inch wheels. The other problem with the 18-inch wheel that I found was that the wheel well is feeling a little empty, and a set of 19s would make this car look properly badass. The radio antenna is now a shark fin style antenna, and you've got a slightly sportier rear spoiler, which looks rather pretty, and the whole car overall now looks a bit more mature and a little bit more sophisticated, making it look rather premium. After a fun day out with the Jeep Meridian Overland, I can say that I'm pretty happy with the car. It was smooth on the highways and it was frugal too. It gave us 16.5-ish kilometers to the liter. It also was rather easy to drive off-road, and the best thing it was that it was rather capable when you pushed it up the hill, making this a very nice single car garage. And if you're that kind of person that needs a large SUV with a third row for the extra space and something that is rather premium, the Jeep Meridian Overland is something you definitely should test out, because it just fits your bill so much better than the counterpart from Japan. With that being said, definitely go out and get a test ride of this Jeep Meridian, because you will not be disappointed. And that being said, I'm gonna go head to the cafe, have a little coffee, and then leave for the office back to my mundane life. Thank you so much for watching. Do let us know your thoughts on the Jeep Meridian 4x4 in this Overland variant. And would you pick it over any other car in its competition? Thank you so much for watching. It's been your boy Vavneet. I'll see you in the next one.